Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today we're going to unclog this capping station for L1800. It's the same thing as 1430. We'll get a syringe with adapter and we pull from the outlet of the tube. If you just pull vacuum, that means the tubes are clogged inside. Second thing to do is just pause for a minute and say why me 10 times. And start understanding about this capping station. And this is the capping platform, and it's tied by this little spring. You're gonna lose this spring sometime in the future. Make sure you know where to get it. Go to bchtechnology.com and looking for L1800 little, and it's called a little spring for L1800 waste capping station. And this little guy right here, you're gonna lost it. I just know it. Oh, first let's get a syringe. And I was using 100 mil, you can get a 50 mil, and you get 100 mil. The difference, 100 mil, you get this spiral thing, you can twist the adapter on. And for adapter, just looking for accessories. Syringe and needles, and get this four-piece plastic refill adapter. It can both be twisted inside at that 100 mil, or if I have a regular syringe, you can just put it outside. You can see the platform can be twisted left and right, and you won't be flat, so the rubber seal can suck on the printhead. The pad looks clean, so I'm checking the wiper. Here's a rubber wiper on the side, and you can see there are lots of dried ink on it. So I just get a tweezer and start peeling it. Otherwise, the wiper cannot effectively wipe the printhead clean. And that's why sometimes it's not clogged, but you still get either strikes or printhead scratching on the surface of the film. And I use my finger to check whether the bladder gonna bounce back. So the rubber is still good. So I don't need to replace the wiper. I just need to clean it. This tube is called air tube. It's go to the right hand side if you hold it this way, and goes to right hand side of the platform. As normally you shouldn't get anything there, but if it's really bad, this tube can be clogged. I start by checking if the spring for the lever is still good. That controls the air hole, whether it's open and closed. It looks good. And the air hole go to the right side of the platform. You can see the opening from the top. The other tube I call the sucking tube. It starts from the center of the platform and it goes to here. And it goes all the way to the manifold. And when it goes to the manifold, it's split into two tubes. And the tube goes inside a peristaltic pump. It is a big word, but basically you just get something to turn it inside, run, and the massage tube. And the tube get squeezed outside here and combined into one tube and dump out. So we already suck on that dump tube and draw vacuum. So the ink must be clogged somewhere. There are lots of time your printer doesn't have problem with your printhead. It's funny because your capping station is clogged. So you print blank. And then you buy a new printhead, it still prints blank. Of course, there are like a whole bunch of reasons for doing that, but actually capping station is one of them, get overlooked. So you change the printhead and then you change the motherboard, eventually you figure out actually it's your cap station. We're gonna check this air tube first. We disconnect it and we throw over syringe and adapter. We're gonna draw. Yeah, I can draw air, but it feel like some resistance, and this should be like clearly open, so I got some water in the syringe. I suspect there's some dried ink inside the tube, and that's where you can find the platform is foamy, and that means some ink gets into this tube. And so I push, and I still feel resistance. Let's get some water. For cap station, we don't need distilled water, just regular water or tap water will be fine. So I fill the syringe with water, and then I push, and so it can clean the tube. You can see the ink come off as black or blue. So I do it a couple times until I get the whole tube cleaned. And then I reattach the tube. Now on the left side, there's another black tube. Remember I said the dust goes into the peristaltic pump and then go out. So I disconnect that one and start sucking. And I was wishing a good news is I can suck on that, but it doesn't work. You can see how upset I was. I have to walk around and reset some pumps. I wrote a lot of poems about cleaning the cap station, and they all made up with four-letter words. Okay, feel better. It's not that you draw vacuum, it's the resistance you're going to feel. Okay, after you do a couple of them, the resistance. Remember, it's split into two tubes. Sometimes one of the tube got clogged. So that's the reason that your pump is not functional 100%. So we're going to completely open up this cap station and clean every tube. We're going to open up this assembly. Once you open it up, all the gear is going to be everywhere. And I suggest you take a video of every step so you know how to put it back. If you cannot figure out, we have 27 minutes video for showing the mechanical parts and show you how to assemble is something disassembled. You're going to put it back. If you want to see the video, you can go to bchtechnologies.com and search for capping. Yeah, right here. You can see this video, and we're going to show you take down everything down and put everything back. Also, we'll show you how to test it. Don't worry, you will be able to put it back. We need to make sure the ink is open from the platform to the black tube, to the end of the black tube. So we disconnect the black tube from the manifold, and one side, this white square, is simulate printhead. So it's sucking the clear water from the tank. And you can see on the 100 ml syringe how dirty it is. However, it's open, so it just cleaned the platform. So we know the platform to the end of the black tube is clean. And of course, I just don't want to repeat myself. If you need this white square, just go to the description of this video. I'm going to put a link there, and so you click on it and go to bchtechnology.com and you can buy it. I call this thing white sucker. It cleans up this platform. It has multiple holes, so it can clean it evenly. However, you have to pay attention to this thing, this air hole. So when you push this lever in, the air hole be open. You're not sucking from the sucker, you're sucking from the air. And the printer controls this lever by going up and down, and when it goes down, the lever gets pushed, you won't be able to suck. This sucker cleans from the platform up all the way to the end of this tube. However, if you suck from the outlet, you are actually cleaning up the whole system. So you can use this for regular cleaning without taking the whole cabin station out. You can just suck from the outlet of the waste tube as a daily maintenance. Here, because my station is totally clogged, I have to clean section by section. So I disconnected the black tube from the manifold, and now I'm sucking it. It's better to have a two-person, it's a two-person job, but today I'm all by myself, so I'm doing it alone. Now the platform is totally cleaned, and we can focus on the manifold. Before moving to the manifold, just make sure that the platform can be raised evenly, and make sure there are no debris on the platform. Sometimes you get dried ink there, cannot be washed out. If this sounds too tedious, we also have a service on our website. We can service your CAP station. Everything will be done right, so you don't have to spend like hundreds of dollars to get a new CAP station. Okay, all checked out. Okay, and so those clamps, basically you just twist a little bit and pull it straight up, and twist it a little bit, and you can pull it straight up and disconnect the tube. And you hope you get liquid ink inside tube. And if you pull off, it's rubbery, and that's a bad sign. It's easy to clean rubbery tubes, but I found the number 2 brush is perfect for this size tube. I'm going to put a link to the brush if you need it in the description. We're going to disconnect the clip, and we need to clean both channels of a clip. I'll use an unclogging needle and poke in and remove the rubber stuff. The part of what I'm working on is the outlet of the capping station, which the ink already went through the peristaltic pump. Then they come together and get into this tube to dump into the waste tank. And see that. And you have two channels, they come together. So you need to unclog both channels. Some capping station only get one channel clogged, another one is not clogged. What you have is it's not functioning 100%. So that's why you cannot tell the pump is bad, but however, it doesn't suck strong enough. Eventually, you're going to clog the printhead. Now get some water, and I want to see ink coming out from both channels. You can see one channel completely get white, it become white, and all the clog are gone, but the red channel is still completely blocked, so I need to work on it more. Now both channels are clean, and I can put everything together. And we do the same thing for the ink intake. We already unclog from the platform all the way to the ink intake. Now we clean the ink intake and outtake. Now the only thing left is the tube that's going inside the peristaltic pump. And to do this, there is no easy way. You have to take the tubes out. To take the tubes out, you need actually unassemble the whole thing. And you can just follow my tutorial video, and which I walk you step by step how to test it and how to put it back. And if you don't want to do that, I suggest to take a detailed video how each step is done. So if you get stuck, you can roll your video back and see how to do it. Once you learn how to do it, it's not that hard to do. It just takes time. It takes about half an hour to get everything together and take it apart and get everything together. And then you add about 20-30 minutes to clean up all the tubes. So if you don't want to do it yourself, you can just send it to us and let us do it. Okay, once you get to the pump and disassemble the pump, and that's the fun part. Now you just unclog and push all those ink out. And it'll be as good as new and totally clean. And so after that, you can put it together, and we're going to do a test. And you want to see the ink can flow through the tube and get it dumped out into the waste tank. And also you want to see the platform can raise and going down, and eventually there's no errors and the printer can do a complete self-cleaning routine. Those of you who follow my channel know this channel is actually a fly fishing channel disguised as a printer repair channel. This is a blue-green vacation harbor lights. And now it's like a $96 a night, super nice room. And inside the resort, you got two lakes that you can fishing. Actually, you don't even need to bring your fishing rod. You can rent a regular spinner rod at a front desk for $5 a day. And also they have a free pass to the state parks. The state park also has a pier. And so if you want to fish in the lakes, they have two lakes. And they don't allow you to fish at intercoastal way. So let me zoom out so you can know where this is. So you can either go to State Park, and if you want to get some fishing in the sea, or you can fishing in here, and you have to check in the coastal way. The hotel doesn't allow you to fish on their property. However, you can walk down this path. I don't know who owns this, if you can fish here. The opposite, there's like lots of private houses. I guess you cannot fish in there. You can see on the opposite of the intercoastal way, there are a bunch of houses and a boathouse. And then the resort, the way going to curve to your right. However, I think if you get a fishing rod, just go down there, and I don't know who owns it. So you guys, I guess nobody's going to see you, so I guess you can fish there. Anyway, don't park at the resort. They're going to tow your car. And here's their lakes, and there are tons of fish in the lakes. And I use a spinner rod and get so tired of fishing spinner rod because there are so many fish for every bite, big fish. So I just challenged myself, turning into fly fishing, and that was fun. Oh, I will be in Avon, Colorado from September 29th to October 6th. So if I get any of you really want to join me for fly fishing, just let me know so we can meet up somewhere and go fishing. My plan is go hike first, hike up to the mountain and hike to an alpine lake and fish in the alpine lake so I can get both hiking and fishing down. Okay, don't be a NARP and be active. Get off your butts and start fixing the printers or go fishing with me. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us www.bchtechnology.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.